Hello children, in the previous lesson we saw different changes in families happen because of different incidents. We saw Nimi's family, a baby was born into Nimi's family. Then in Sharing's family, his father got a promotion and got transferred to another city. And in Asli's family, a wedding happened and a new bride entered into the family. So these are some of the changes that you come across, and then we saw some other changes also that happen in a family when some natural calamities occur. People may have to change the place where they live and all those things. Similarly, when children in the family go for higher studies, they move to they move to boarding schools, etc., there again changes happen. So here is a table given. Talk to three old people, one from your family, one from your friend's family, and one from a family in your neighborhood. Ask them these questions and fill in the table. Since how many years has your family been staying there? Where did your family live before coming here? How many members are there in your family today? How many members were there in your family 10 years ago? What were the reasons for the change in your family in the last 10 years? How do you feel about all these changes? What problems do you face with changes in technology? So these are some of the questions. When new technologies come into existence, definitely the elder people in the family will find it difficult to get adjusted to the new changes. Like mobile phones, varumbo adubole mobile phones nu initially mobile phones vannu, from there it got switched to touch screen phones. You might have experienced that they find it difficult to get adjusted to these changes. Then computers came into existence. Not many of them know how to use computers. There are a lot of things that can be done through a computer. All these changes, they find it difficult. Then the use of ATM cards. You might have seen some of the elderly people finding it difficult to use ATM cards. All these things, like when technology changes, any change is initially difficult for anyone to adapt to. So the elderly people find it even more difficult to adjust to these changes. My family, yesterday, today and tomorrow. All families change in some way or the other because of different reasons. Has your family changed too? When your grandmother and grandfather were children like you, was your family just like it is today? Do you remember the picture? This we have not done, so I'll not read that. You have also drawn a family tree of your own. Let us again draw the family tree. See here, I have a picture of the family tree. This is you. Okay, you can draw picture, draw boxes for your siblings here, right here. This is your mother. Then this is your mother's grandmother, mother's mother, then mother's father, his mother and father, your grandmother's mother and father. You can put your grandmother's siblings here, brothers, sisters, mother and family. You can write it here. Then grandfather, his family. His brothers, sisters, etc. You can put it here. So, this is a sample family tree. So, right at the bottom, you will find yourself and your brothers and sisters over here. This is the tree. This is the branch that shows your mother's family. And this is the branch that shows your father's family. So, you had also drawn a family tree of your own family. So let us draw a family tree in our notebook. You can draw a family tree in your notebook. Your family tree in your notebook. Ask your grandmother or grandfather how many members were there in their family when they were your age. Then draw a family tree in your notebook of their family when they were young. Can you see yourself, your brother or your sister, your mother or your father anywhere in this family tree? When you draw your grandmother's family tree, you will not see avare childhood days le family tree varichinjale, you will not see any of these people in their family tree. You will not see your mother or father in the family tree. You will not find yourself in the family tree. Now draw a family tree of your present family in your notebook. This is what we saw here as well. So this is a sample family tree. You can complete this tree. Can you tell in what ways the family tree of your grandmother or grandfather in their childhood is different from your family tree today? When you talk to your grandmother or grandfather, you will see that they were living in a joint family. They used to live with their uncles, aunts, their children. The family used to be very big. Like they used to, it used to be joint family. Now, when we look at our own families, you can see it will be father, mother, children. Probably some of you will have grandparents living with you. Some of you may not even have grandparents with you. The size of the family and number of children in the family have come down. Up to which class do you want to study? You can write up to which class you want to study. Up to which class have your parents studied? Some of your parents would have studied engineering, medicine, graduates, postgraduates, some of them might be PhDs, MPhils, like researchers. Some of your parents might have studied only up to 12th standard. All these, some of your parents might not have received formal education. Yeah, so you can write up to where your parents have studied. Till which class did your grandmother get a chance to study? When you talk to your grandmothers, probably you will see most of your grandmothers are graduates. But when I talk of my grandmother, they rarely had chance to study beyond 4th standard or 5th standard. Yeah. At what age did your grandmother get married? You can talk to your grandmother and find out at what age they got married. Most of them would have got married by the age of 18 or 20. I'm talking about most of them. Some of them would have got married probably a little later. Some of them even earlier as well. Have you heard of a law that talks about the ages before which the girls and boys must not be married? Girls in a marriage and age is 18 years legally. Girls are not supposed to be married before they are 18 years of age, and for boys it is 21 years. Now recently I came across an article in TV wherein a 15 year old girl was to be married to a boy. The age of the boy is not clear. So the girl was just 15 years and she was about to get married. But there are some help groups set up by the government that saves children who are married before they are 18 years of age, which is illegal. That is, law permits an age 18 years. So this girl was trying to be married away by her parents when she was just 15 years old. So some people reported that she was getting married before her marriageable age, which was against the law, and she was rescued from her family. So there are groups that help children. Child marriage is illegal. 18 years before right, girls in a marriage illegal. So government, there are certain government agencies that help. Namla report idu kaiyinjala anganeilla kuttile save edittu they are allowed to continue what they want to do. അതായത് സ്റ്റഡീസ് കണ്ടിന്യൂ ചെയ്യാനും ഒക്കെ ഹെൽപ്പ് ചെയ്യണ ഗവൺമെന്റ് ഏജൻസീസ് യു വിൽ കം അക്രോസ്. സോ റീസെന്റ്ലി ദർ വാസ് എൻ ആർട്ടിക്കിൾ ഇൻ പേപ്പർ, ഐ ഡോണ്ട് ആർട്ടിക്കിൾ ഇൻ ടി വി, ഐ ഡോണ്ട് നോ ഇഫ് യു ഹാവ് കം അക്രോസ് ഇറ്റ്. So for girls, the age when they can get married is 18, and for boys it is 21. The rest of this chapter we'll discuss in our next session, children. Please go through the video. In case if you have any doubts, please do post it in the stream. That's all for today. Thank you and take care.